Hi, my name is Pawel, I make games, and I'm gonna show you how to loop your own animation. We've written it in the previous video, and stop the coroutine which holds it as a given condition is met. First, we will need a new boolean, and because we will use it for looping our animation, let's call it loop. And it will be our first condition in sprite animator. Let's say if data.loop, which is the same as if data.loop is true, we will set I to 0. Let's see how it looks like now. In Unity, let's check loop boolean and enter play mode. Now as we go to the plant, we are stuck at the first frame. That's because we need to add something to this statement. And it will be if I is bigger or equal to sprite's amount. That means we are displaying the last frame now. That's the only time we want to loop the animation. As you can see, we are looping the animation. And you may wonder why do we check if I is greater than sprite's amount. We set it back to 0 if it's equal to this number, and we increase it by only 1 every step, so it never goes above this number, and it's just an extra protection. And I think it would be better to change the 15 frames of gap to 9. Let's see how it looks like now. And for me, it looks better. Feel free to experiment with this. Our functions won't depend on this number anyway. It's just the visuals. Alright, now it's time to the harder part, stopping the animation. We will need a coroutine, it may be private, and let's name it previous animation. Next step is going to be creating a public void play animation. We'll need an animation data there, so let's copy and paste it. Oh, we can have two functions with the same name, so let's add coroutine at the end of our IEnumerator. And we will check if our previous animation is not equal to null, which means there is something in this variable. And if it's true, we will just stop this coroutine. And if it's empty, we will simply play the animation and store it in this value. We'll just copy this coroutine, remove animation data type, and also write start coroutine at the beginning. Now, as we are able to start this coroutine using this public void, we may get rid of start coroutine in our click manager. Now we are using just a regular function. That way we will be able to stop it in the future. Now let's click on the plant. And as you can see, nothing has changed, which is good, because that means we didn't break anything. Our job is not done yet, because we need to stop this animation somehow. Guess the best place to do this is update scene after action. It is happening as we reach the target. Instead of player animation 1 from game manager, we will just use null. And we want it to play base animation if null is here. In sprite animator, we will check if our data is equal to null, which means we don't have any data. And if it's true, we will use our base animation as our data. As I remember, our idle animation is still empty, so let's put there our sprite number 12. And we may leave everything as it is. We have only one sprite, so we don't need frames of gap, and we won't need to loop it because there is only one sprite. Now, as we enter the play mode and click on the plant, we are going towards it, and we stop eventually, but the animation just freezes and we don't go to the idle state. It turns out that we don't need this else in play animation. You know, it would be silly if the play animation function doesn't play any animations if it's called. That's why we need to start a coroutine every time we call this function. Not only if the previous animation is empty. And now we are finally moving towards the target and stopping and collecting it as we reach it. That's great! You may tell me in the comments how great it is, and see you in the next video! If you've reached that far and your game works without any issues, that means you did a pretty good job. In the next episode, we are going to create a name tag for our items, which I think is something awesome to have in the game. Have a good day and see you soon!